Determine the FH and FA force per unit width surface AB as shown in the figure and the curved surface in the form of quadrant of a circle of radius of 1.5 meter. The curved circle is a form of circle, so it will not going to displace any quantity of liquid. The height is given as 2 meter and this center is distance radius is 2 meters. So let's compare this with our situation here. The liquid is really present above the gate. So this corresponds to our situation number 1. So using the situation number 1, we can calculate our FE. So FE will be equals to rho into G into V and FH. So we have FE equal to rho G into V, that is the volume above the gate AB. And since the water is really present, the force will be acting downward. So where to, it consists of basically two areas. One area is CD, AE and other is quarter circle. So ADCE is 2 meter by 1.5 meter multiplied by width is 1 plus. The quarter circle is 1 by 4 into pi r square into width 1 meter. So we have 1 by 4 into pi into 1.5 square, that is the area of circle divided by 4 and width is 1. So answer is 46.75 kN. Now we want to calculate the horizontal force. So what we do is that we'll project the AB on a vertical surface. The projection is represented by AF. So this AF has a height of same as 1.5 meter. So the centroid of this portion will be lies exactly halfway at this point, that is G. And we can measure the distance from A. So this is 1.5 divided by 2 is 0.75. Now you have to measure the edge bar distance always from free surface. So 0.75 plus 2, that is equal to 2.75. So we have FH equal to rho G into edge bar into A projected. Rho G is as well 9810. Edge bar is 2.75. And projected area, the height for this one is 1.5 meter. And the width is given as 1. So we have 40.66 kN. Let's consider here the second problem. And in this case, we want to find out a force on AB, only vertical force we want to find out. Now this situation we'll compare with our standard 3 situation first. So some water is present below this. It means that some imaginary column will act over here. See, this situation is same as our situation number 2, that is this situation. So in this case, the water below it will force it upward. So we'll consider here one imaginary liquid column and we'll use this formula and calculation of FH will remain same. So we'll consider this imaginary area, that is ABCD. The height of this one is 5 meter. We are rho g into V bar and but the force will act vertically upward because of imaginary column. Rho g is 9810. Cross section area is 5 meter by 2 meter and the width is 1 meter, so multiplied by 1. So our answer is 98100 newtons or 98.1 kilonewton. This time we have cylindrical gate holding the water on one side only and we want to calculate only vertical force. So you have to imagine the situation that if there is no gate, then what will happen? So if there is no gate, then this column is filled. So this column was initially filled, but as soon as we place the gate, that volume is displaced. The volume displaced will be semicircular. So this one is our case number 3. You have to calculate FE by using buoyant force concept. So this concept is same as this concept, that is the volume is displaced. So volume displaced will be area multiplied by cross section, that is semicircular area multiplied by width. And FE in this case will act vertically upward because of buoyant force. So FE equal to rho into G, that is 9810. Volume displaced will be equal to the cross section area of this part, that is semicircle, is 1 by pi by 4 into 2 square is circle area multiplied by 1 by 2 for semicircle. Width is given as 1. So this answer is 1540 1.7 newton per meter. So choice C is correct choice. Now in this one, if the question appears in 2001 gate exam, we are given one semicircular plate. The center of this one is at depth equal to h. We have to calculate fx and fy on the semicircular gate. So this situation is just as the previously we have discussed. So first of all, we'll calculate vertical force. So what is semicircular gate, then this water is get displaced. So because of this, so the vertical force will be equals to the buoyant force. Force is given by rho into g into v displaced. So rho into g as it is, we want to calculate the volume displaced. So volume displaced is this section. This section is 1 by 2 pi r square. Pi r square is the area of the complete circle. This is semicircle, so this is 1 by 2. And multiplied by the width, that equal to multiplied by w. So this answer corresponds to this answer. We have pi here. Then we have rho, then we have g, r square, w by 2. That is this answer. Now we want to calculate fx force. To calculate fx force, we have to visualize this area as on this vertical plane. So that area will look like this, and the centroid of this plate is same as the center of this one, that is this point. So this height and this height is same, so this will be h bar, whereas the vertical length of this one will be equal to 2r. Projected area is given by rho into g into h bar multiplied by area. So rho into g will be as it is, h bar will be replaced by h. Projected area is 2r multiplied by width w. So this answer is this answer, 2 times rho times g times h times r omega. So this time the choice D is correct. So in this case we are given a dam having a curved surface, and the equation of this one is given as y is equal to x square by 4. At this point we have origin, and this axis is x axis, this axis is y axis, and this vertical distance is given as 20 meter, and the density of water is this, and 9.81. You want to calculate horizontal force acting on the dam per unit width. So whenever you have to calculate the horizontal force, you have to take the projected area. So if you look from this side, that is the water side, this curved surface will look like this. So this height will be equals to 20 meter. Centroid of this portion is here, because the centroid at exactly halfway, we have value of h bar equal to 20 by 2, that equal to 10 meter. Width in this case we are given as per unit width length, you have to calculate this. So our area will be 20 multiplied by 1, and the height equal to this value. Horizontal force is given by product of rho into g into h bar multiplied by projected area. Rho is 1000, g is 9.81, h bar is 10, and projected area is 20 multiplied by 1. So this answer is 1.962 10 to the power 6. Suppose in this problem he want to know what is the vertical force. So for vertical force we should know the area of this part, that is this cross section, and this water is really present, so therefore the weight of this liquid will act downward. So we have to just calculate the volume displaced here, that is the, if we know the cross section of this one and multiplied by width, that will be volume multiplied by rho g. So if this height is equal to 20 meter, then you can put here 20 meter, and we can calculate the x coordinate of this point. So this 20 into 4 is 80, under root of 80 is 8.94 meter. So this coordinate is 8.94 meter. To calculate the area, we should know this area, this hatch area. To consider this, to know this hatch area, we should consider here one vertical strip, or what we can do, we can take one horizontal strip also. So this horizontal strip is moving from this point, that is x equal to 0, x equals to 8.94. And the height of this strip is 20 meters minus this value of y. So this height is y1, we'll call it is y, and this y is equal to 20 meters. Whereas the bottom height from here is on the curve. So this one is our y2, is same as y, and y is equal to x square by 4. So this elemental area has a height is y1 minus y2, and the thickness is dx. y1 minus y2, that is the total height of this strip, yellow strip, and multiplied by dx. Total area will be equal to integral of this area, y1 is equal to 20 minus y2 is equal to x square by 4 multiplied by dx. So we have to put the lower limit of dx equal to 0, and the upper limit of x is 8.94. Integral of this 20 with respect to dx is 20x. Integral of x square is x cube, and this 4 is divided by 3, so it is x square x cube by 12. Lower limit is 0 and upper limit is 8.94. So this cross section come out to be 119.25 meter square. Once we know the cross section, we'll multiply it by width, and hence we can find out vertical force. So we have Fe equal to rho g multiplied by cross section area multiplied by width. Here rho g is 9810. Area we have calculated is 119.25. Width is not given, that equal to 1. Remember this extra work that we are doing. Approximate answer is 1170 kilonewton. A cylindrical roller gate has a diameter equal to 3 meter is placed in such a way that the dam water is about to flow over it. The length of the cylindrical gate, roller gate is 6 meter, that is perpendicular to the plane is 6 meter. You want to find out FH and we want to find out FB. Suppose we don't have this roller gate, then this volume is filled by the same liquid. It means that due to insertion of this one, the volume is get displaced. So vertical force will be acting upper force. Vertical force is given by the product of rho into g into volume displaced is same as buoyant force. So rho for water is 1000, g is 9.81, so rho g is 9810, and the cross section of this one is 1 by 2 into pi by 4 into 3 square, and the length perpendicular to the plane will be equal to 6 meter. So this answer will be equals to 208.03 kilonewton. Now next job is to calculate FH. So if you want to calculate the FH, you have to visualize from this side. So this cylindrical portion will look like a flat plate, and therefore the height of this one is 3 meters. So centroid will be exactly at this point. So this one is G. So this one is our H bar, and H bar is 3 by 2, that is 1.5. of H as a product of rho multiplied by G multiplied by H bar multiplied by projected area. Rho into G is 9810, H bar is 1.5, projected area of this plane, so height of this plane is 3 meter, and the perpendicular to the plane, the length is given as 6 meter. So this answer is 264.87 kilonewton. So this is a very simple way to calculate this. Just identify your bodies, whether we have the case number 1 or case number 2 or case number 3. If the liquid is really present, then the force will act vertically downward. If we have imaginary liquid and liquid is forcing it upward, then we have imaginary column, and in that case the formula remains same, only thing that direction is upward. And if the some volume is get displaced, so you apply the calculate buoyancy force is same as Fe, and all these three modules, the calculation of